last fall. Okay? Yeah. It's also my first attempt at an epic. And I call it Kenda Muiyuru, or in English, I shall be calling it the perfect nine. Right? I want to tell you a little bit about that perfect nine. The Kikuyu people say that he's whispering to me, telling me, you know, don't tell them the secret. Just tell me alone, but I'll anybody, but I was always very bothered by description of our clans. There was never negativity all the time, even when people are very proud of their clans, you know. They would say, oh, that clan has witches or something, is very good with witchcraft. Or that clan sold a child for whatever, I mean, very negative things. It bothered for a long time, but I did not know what to do about it. until sometime in the, at the University of California, Irvine, overlooking the Pacific Ocean, I realized this. Those 10 girls or women did not have any brothers, okay? So really, literally, there's one man and 11 women. So those girls had to do everything. They must have known, and they must have known how to build, how to make things, right? They must have known how to make weapons to defend themselves. So they must have made weapons, okay? They must have known how to hunt, everything. And they must have known how to plan, use their mind. And I felt like a revelation, literally. And in fact, I thought this was, wait a minute, these are actually the original feminists, right? So one night, literally, I woke up and started writing the epic. And it says, generally, I'll give you a brief outline. The 9 daughters, or 10 daughters, were born in the shadow of Mount Kenya. Oh my God, they were so beautiful. And 9 ostriches that rode on the waves, on the wind, like horses, with a trumpets, these their beaks as trumpets, talking about their beauty. Okay. And wherever young men were in the continent, each would see the beauty in their dreams, and each would wake up to pursue this dream of beauty in their minds, the beauty in their dreams. They would follow the rivers, whatever was the nearest river, but then they found other young men had similar ideas, pursuing this beauty. They followed the major rivers of the continent towards the mountain of the moon, or the mountain of ostrich whiteness, what we call Mount Kenya. Some fell on the wayside, others this. So only 99 passed, came to the the home of Ikoyo and Mombi. Now, remember there are 10 women, 99 men. Go tell them, Mombi, tell them now. Now you have to prove who you are, testing. Eh? You go back to the mountain and bring me each some handful or whatever in a gourd of that moon whiteness that's on Mount Kenya. Bring it home. At the same time, I want something else. Let me explain. The 9th daughter, who normally is not hardly mentioned in a myth, is called Warigia. And she's born without firm legs, okay? So she is, how shall I say, grown woman, except for the legs. But there's a cure for her. And the cure lies in a hair that cures all, and the hair grows in the middle of the tongue of a man eating ogre. Okay? Right? And something more, the ogre actually is invisible. Except for the tongue, occasionally, when it comes to capture anyone. So, this is the task they are given. But the girls are not left behind. They go with them. They'll go through whatever difficulties they come through. They'll be part of the challenges they meet on the way. Okay. Of course, you're going to read the rest for yourself. But let me tell you, again, they were mothers or matriarchs of the 9 clans of Ngugi people. you have heard of them, Ngugi?
Some of them.
Oh, can you tell us a little bit about one of them, maybe? Can you come here?
Sure.
Okay. Is there a one boy here?
A one boy, right here.
One boy?
Yes.
One boy, ni mmoja tu. One boy.
One boy.
One boy.
One boy.
Okay.
The clan. Okay, the clan of one boy. What do they say about the clan of one boy?
One boy, ni na wa one boy. Ati mwomboi erago endiye kahe jahe ni ngara kumwalimu.
Ni kwe jiku waka.
Asha. Mwomboi aga tumye kahe lele ado ilio hide ya ngara hu. Kakishoka na kiyodo keyuru jahe maho na makirana. Kahe kiyondo ngongo. Mukwa kiongo taka iretu na tuwahona. Kae, nema kahe na kairetu kutile utaangie honoki ya bururie. Omba kakiondo agitaraga ajata, amenye midire ya leo ode. Na wabu ini mwara? Hile? Ato ongoli liye butu, engongo ini wa wabu imele edu.
Nyamishore.
Wabu inyamishore. Nemo meo hii? Zebra? Aha. Zoyono huo, hii, nyamishore eke heni ya wero ine, no matimuna hiyo, ze magidara.
Hei, wapo inake.
Wapo ine mo hiyo. Na, reke kwele yo dogi. Na, kaine kere ole ruwai.
Yo kwa hiyo rito haliwe.
Asha. Agada ira hadu anake moine kaga ngiko ni kwihobora
aiya
muhereka wake obodo kago kwagatiri abo moito e osiyo ne wa boy yo
kwa kwilo kobio moito ro amada
yo ro amada
bone kai te ni kwa
sana wangare one of the daughters was called wangare kuna wangare hapa. Ah, right there.
Oh, yes.
This one is dedicated to you. Wangari. Nina wa angari. Muheka. Muheka. Nyanjiri. Wangari. Nina wa angari. Muheka wake o kaga okauga. Ah, wangare ito eh! Wangari euro meta wangari na maigo make utheri otaguo e metuketa ya ngari akirangira utari akiranguoni ari amari na ndimwara ateririe wira andu mambe mahune thuma mauro akira makiuruta na hinya na kio na wendo aike irie garege singai yona vade liera ine ikiura na siomboli ike honoka oiga garalisi ya konora mesiria ni inoro lea muoyo no garalisi ya konora yo ni inoro lea gekuo wangaline kiro lewa ate kwe muanake watu ile ahumbirite guoko mwalimu, hali ya aga idilio ni wangari, ati orugari ushio. Nukana nyugu wone liyowa.
I had said that their father and mother were Iko and Mombi. And although we say that they were brought there by God, because the Gikoyo people never say they did things by them. They always say, God helped me do this. God made me come to the mountain. So, But in my narrative, they must have come from elsewhere, but came to the mountain, but they don't say, I brought myself to the mountain. They say, God, you know. And they were, oh my God, when they, oh yes. When they came to the top of the mountain, they saw the beauty of the land in front of them, and were totally, that's how they knew they had got to the right place. That's why they said God brought them there, because the beauty of the land was absolutely mesmerizing, and they simply fell into a song, or they broke into a song.
Yoda koyo wakenga take teri oyo joana yemanyinge ona yamu milemba mingi maho amaya iri waku betena nyamu hamwe na nyoni na shongoyo joine nandi aine siumbe siode iri waku wadikiriria Iwa mugambo, wakunga yo kiwoda koyo wode, watwa dena tura matewega, kirorerwa diri wakumwega, leke, kirorerwa diri wakumwega.
If you want to read more about the clan and of your clan and what happened to all that, of course, the book is selling outside, I believe. Kenda Muiyuru. It will eventually be translated into English and it has a perfect nine. And I understand there is a translation about to go into operation, into Kipsigis. And so we might actually see it translated to other African languages before the English one, or at about the same time. And Kiswahili, I hope. Thank you.